The U.S. Army has charged Private Travis King with desertion after he dashed into North Korea. According to a document obtained by Reuters, the case includes 8 charges under the Uniform Code of Military Justice, setting up a substantial legal battle for the 23-year-old soldier who was released from North Korean custody in September. King dashed into the North in July while on a civilian tour of the heavily fortified border. Pyongyang claimed King was escaping discrimination in the U.S. Army. South Korea will observe the first anniversary of the Itaewon crowd surge, which killed 159 people during a Halloween celebration, with the families of the victims still seeking justice. This report.
It's been a year since Song Jin-young lost his daughter. At 20, Jae-rim was entering the prime of life, learning to design and sell her own clothes. In her bedroom, perusing her belongings. That's the closest Song can now get to his daughter.
We just aren't prepared to make any changes to this space. I think we can only do that when we're ready to let her go. But we just aren't ready yet.
Jae-rim was one of 159 people killed during a Halloween celebration crowd surge in South Korea's Itaewon neighborhood. For parents, it was an unimaginable horror. Song called his daughter's phone hundreds of times, but couldn't confirm she was dead for 12 hours. Jae-rim's phone still receives messages from friends, including some who are with her in Itaewon.
I want to have a clear idea of why all this happened. What kind of first aid was my child given? How was she moved to the morgue? I still have no idea.
To cope with the pain, Song has relied on the support of others who lost family in Itaewon. Here, they make ribbons to keep the memories of their loved ones alive. Jin Chang-hee lost her 21-year-old niece.
This allows us to laugh while we think about the children. Our friendship becomes stronger, and we can relieve some of the tiredness that has accumulated from struggling for a year.
So far, no one has been found criminally responsible for the disaster. One government minister was impeached, but a court later reversed that decision, saying blame shouldn't lie with one person. A government spokesperson said President Yoon Suk-yeol remains heartbroken and deeply sorry over the incident. For Song and many others grieving, that is impossible to accept.
In the future, I think those responsible for preventing disasters should take some responsibility.
It's a search for answers while bearing indescribable pain. Bill Gallo, VOA News, Seoul, South Korea.
Top Hollywood stars offering $150 million to the SAG-AFTRA Actors Union in an attempt to end their strike. That offer confirmed by Oscar winner actor George Clooney, saying the money could help fund efforts to improve their health benefits. Clooney adds, top stars would only collect in residuals once lower paid actors receive theirs.
So I talked with Fran yesterday several times. And one of the things she said, and I said this before, but it's important to say it out loud, because this, you know, when talks break down, everything gets, everybody worries, right? It's worrisome. And by the way, you know, there's IATSE is here, and they're worried because they've got a lot of members that have been, you know, 100% unemployed.
Members of the SAG-AFTRA have been on strike since July. Talks between the union and the Alliance of Motion Picture and Television Producers broke down last week, dashing hopes for a quick resolution. Republican lawmaker Jim Jordan still not backing down in his bid for the House speakership. After a closed-door meeting with his fellow Republicans, Jordan said he would press ahead with a third vote. This comes after his fellow Republicans abandoned a backup plan to allow the leaderless chamber to resume business. The White House has been without a leader. Make that the House has been without a leader for over 2 weeks now, following Jordan's 2 failed attempts to secure the 217 votes needed to claim the Speaker's gavel. It is not yet clear when the House would vote again. U.S. President Joe Biden asking Americans to spend billions of dollars more to help Israel fight Hamas as it prepares for a ground invasion of Gaza. Biden delivered a rare Oval Office address late Thursday following an 8-hour visit to Israel. Biden said he will ask Congress on Friday to approve extra funding for Israel, reportedly worth $14 billion. He also stressed the urgency of getting relief to Palestinians in Gaza. The American president also wasted no time ramping up support for Ukraine.
We can't ignore the humanity of innocent Palestinians who only want to live in peace and have an opportunity. You know, the assault on Israel echoes nearly 20 months of war, tragedy, and brutality inflicted on the people of Ukraine. Hamas and Putin represent different threats, but they share this in common. They both want to completely annihilate a neighboring democracy, completely annihilate it. American leadership is what holds the world together. American alliances are what keep us, America, safe. American values are what make us a partner that other nations want to work with. Put all that at risk if we walk away from Ukraine, if we turn our backs on Israel.
Israel's defense minister hints at a looming invasion of Gaza. Speaking to troops stationed near the Palestinian enclave, defense chief Yoav Gallant said they will soon see Gaza from the inside. He also told them to prepare and get organized, saying the command will come.
There is no forgiveness for this thing. Only total annihilation of Hamas organization, terror infrastructures. Everything that has to do with terrorists and whoever sent them. It will take a week. It will take a month. It will take 2 months until we eliminate them. You are not alone in battle.
Israel pounded Gaza with more airstrikes Thursday as Egypt took steps to let in aid. Israel has vowed to annihilate Hamas militants, putting the entire Gaza Strip under a total siege in response to the deadly October 7 attack. The Israeli death toll in the war stands at 1,400. In Gaza, nearly 4,000 have died. British Prime Minister Rishi Sunak follows U.S. President Joe Biden in showing solidarity for Israel. Sunak arrived in Israel Thursday to hold talks with Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. He vowed the U.K. will stand with Israel in its darkest hour. He also welcomed the decision to allow aid into Gaza.
As your friend, we will stand with you in solidarity. We will stand with your people, and we also want you to win.
Can I also say that we have seen the scenes over the past day that have shocked all of us, particularly at the hospital, and we mourn the loss of every innocent life, civilians of every faith, every nationality who have been killed. We also recognize that the Palestinian people are victims of Hamas too. And that is why I welcome your decision yesterday that you took to ensure that routes into Gaza will be opened for humanitarian aid to enter.
The United Nations amplifying calls for an immediate humanitarian ceasefire in Gaza. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres says while the attacks of Hamas on Israel are indeed appalling, the collective punishment being inflicted on the Palestinian people cannot be justified.
In the face of this humanitarian catastrophe, I'm calling for two immediate humanitarian actions. To Hamas, for the immediate and unconditional release of the hostages. To Israel, for immediate and restricted access of humanitarian aid to respond to the most basic needs of the people of Gaza. Civilians in Gaza desperately need core services and supplies, and for that we need rapid and unimpeded humanitarian access. We need food, water, medicine, and fuel now. We need it at scale, and we need it to be sustained.
Around 200 people queued outside a mall in Makati City for the midnight launch of the iPhone 15 Friday. Some of them even spent the night lining up. But no one can beat the dedication of the first person in line. His name is Joey Reyes. He came all the way from Cebu just to be the first person to get the latest iPhone, make that iPhone model. For more on this story, head on over to news.abs-cbn.com.